They don't drag Solomon Buchi like I pass my neighbor generator.
My correct people them, relationship expert, whether they call and say Solomon Buchi. Him way be relationship expert, now people don't turn back now, they cancel him more. Say, see you this one, you no do well. See the other one, you no do well. No be smart then. Right now, then they drag him more. So they lay in there even disable his Instagram handle because of say, we go write something negative about women. Then women come, they bring out plenty chat of how they beg them money for inbox. Then you go come outside, come talk, say women lazy. No be small thing, no. The first thing we do that time with the first drag him, now when him propose to his girlfriend, propose that way people go just pose, maybe two lines. She said yes. Some people say just three words. Solomon Buchi write novel. You know what me school fees way, so every time Osho says I be speak English. He write novel, oh, being the right is way supposed to write, and waiting no supposed to write, now they can't drag and their face. I bet me when I hear. Oh. He say you are not the most beautiful woman. Ha, this one now applaud have been insult. Say neither are you the most intelligent woman, but like I've chosen to never find perfection in anyone else, I put my gaze on you, and with that commitment, we would mold ourselves. For ourselves, our perfection is in our commitment. Stating that you are not the most beautiful, strong, intelligent, might sound like it's not a compliment, yeah, but it's a realistic base for real love. Acknowledging that my woman isn't the best, but I am not looking for the best. I was looking for you and I found you. There is no best, there is just someone you chose and see the best in them. I beg, I go end there. All this one now for proposal. Don't be smart, you know. No be me go stress so with all this lengthy write up. I don't rest my case for there. So my cry people then people come they beg him or come they drag him. Say why go come they talk say she's not the most beautiful, she's not the most intelligent. Say which kind talk be that one? First person can say this right here is an example of a narcissistic gaslighting, belittling her while making it seem like he's uplifting her. By the way, out of the both of ya all, she's winning in the looks department. As a mental and behavioral health specialist, she should leave. Second person say, you posted a full portrait of that woman's face and open up this post with you are not the most beautiful woman in the world. Audacity must be free on every corner, absolutely. TF not. The last person say, when you were a 5 trying to gaslight your solid 10 partner into thinking they are dating up. My correct people them, if waiting people they think and waiting me are they think not true, you marry this kind sabi man. Hey. Oh, Kotoripo. No be smart, you know. You go hear them. Even when they wrong, you go use talk. Try to claim right, person where you dey engage. Your woman supposed to be the most beautiful for your eye. You say, you are not the most beautiful, you are not the most intelligent. What kind of talk? Is it even necessary? Ha. Now, wow. All right, so my cry people, them that one aside, you see carrying sabi again. I just want to see how they like to do sabi. See carrying sabi again. Can't still come again, can't they write, say, women. They lazy. In fact, make I read them for now. Men, stop dating broke women. They won't help you grow. They will drain you. They need money for everything, even for oxygen. They hate work, but they love soft life. Check their IG. You will think they are millionaires. Avoid dating broke women, but give them jobs if you can. Alright, so 9 people gonna open in Yashu. 9 person gonna say, women are going through a lot. It is not every woman that is financially down or broke that hates to work as suggested in this write-up. This statement has no boundaries
and it suggests that the writer is just being mischievous. A broke woman today may not be a broke woman tomorrow. There are prospects, values, principles, amongst others, you should be on the watch out for, and not just mere finance. Who no get today go get tomorrow. Cheers to all the hardworking women out there striving so hard to make things work. May you succeed. Amen. Oh, she is so right on this. Meanwhile, they are so once upon a time, now my husband been they do everything for me. Everything. But that won't be me, sir. They lazy. No, I was not lazy. How I wish you could get this kind of mindset where this guy gets so. Me and her for no day now, because if I say this one, she don't even get anything. No. Lazy woman. Nine people can't they disgrace him or say he is a lazy, lazy man. He tried to find an easy route by writing, and then he found that two requires a lot of work. Look at how a writer tweets, Buchi Lodo. Then the second person understand people needing a little assistance here and there, but insulting broke babes, then requiring a GoFundMe to have your wedding after begging for funds to buy engagement ring is just... Then the third person say, Emo, they are outing the king of feminism as the king of begging. When I said he is a beggar and a user, people think it's me being an up, somebody that women used to call. That's why sometimes it's good to talk less. Women are emotional beings. See now, they even contribute money given to buy engagement ring. Person will want marry you. Can you imagine? See open GoFundMe for wedding. Like say they own gbese. Now business you won't do. So my character people they come they bring out chat to say many women. Oh, I can't post everything. Plenty women where you know Buchi they meet them for inbox, they beg their money. Make I reach some of them.
Alright, so you say Shebi, you see, everyone thinks I'm a big boy. I am, but now I broke. I am doing a video and I need support like mad. The video is almost 100k. Then the person can reply say, I don't know of anyone, no, but for me, I'm really broke. This recession is buying. Things are hard and money is not circulating. I'm being owed 3 months, but I'm hopeful this month things are not the way they used to. But I refuse to complain. Then I can reply says, well, so you can say, but if something comes up before the end of this week, we'll holler you, dear. Let's be positive. You can say, no pee. That's how crushes should behave. And the person can reply, peace.
So now so many people can they release different chats wherein they beg them for money. I know if you read all, but I still read this one.
Alright, so person can write, say, LOL. It's the recent Instagram people he's been able to scam that's paining me. Everyone on Facebook knows he's been like that. This chat is far back as 2017. We had a conversation about money. He knew I had some money saved and I was trying to put it to good use. He came few days later to stylishly tell me he's broke, hoping I did send some to him. I wasn't even 18 yet, but I had a nonsense not to send shishi. LOL, I am pre-rich. Currently, I need ego right now, like right now. Definitely not 30 billion. Then the person can say, wow, God will provide. Oh, can say, amen, biko.
So now the girl can say, definitely not 30 billion. Kilo day, are you limiting God or what?
If he blesses you with 30 billion, kindly transfer it to me. Oh, then you can say, no, now. I mean right now. I am writing an exam and a lot of things on my slate. 10k right now is all I need. That's why I say definitely not 30 billion, LOL. And if I say, oh.
Okay, another person come post say, and this is how he messages different women as a joke. Anyway, take him seriously. Go and send him something. He goes about testing his luck. And I can say, this you? So the guy first confess with LOL. I see London, I beg you get money. The girl can say, LOL, I try. Can say, can you buy me one of my guitars? Can say, I like this gold guitar. How much is it? I can't say 100. Jesus, this guy is a thief. Can't say 1,005 pounds. Then the person can say, not bad, I can buy it. How do you get it? I can say, LOL, do you actually want to get it? Which one be LOL? Oh, God. 1,005 pounds. Hey. Buchi, no make me shout the one where I go get night visitor. Eh? You don't meet person. Because they follow you. Say, me give you. Hey, Jesus. I be, I no see him well. I be, I they pay me. I just say, whoever say 150 pounds. 1,005 pounds. Let me say too much to dash personal, but how about manna? If you not get money to buy guitar, why not? Cheap ones day now. Guitar of 1,005 pounds. That one, even David Doe. Ha. It's well. Well, my cry people, they don't cast them, and I no pity them because they ain't cost them for himself. Whether they come later buy and the guitar, oh, see, I hear with guitar they play. My cry people, they ain't cost them for himself, oh, because they say, do not buy the finger that fits you. At least women have been sustaining you, helping you. Why you go see con they cast them? And that person can say, I've been following Solomon Buchi case, and I think it escalated to the point where he deactivated his social media account after more embarrassing screenshot appeared on IG. Before I get to my point, I just want to say that creating a crowdfunding account for his wedding isn't new. Americans, for example, crowdfund everything. Weddings, business, buying a house, baby shower, etc. So Solomon didn't do something unheard of. However, I am concerned that he wants to get married while he's not financially stable enough to buy something like an engagement ring and a flight ticket for his woman without asking for help. Planning a wedding is a daunting task people don't want to deal with. The rich hire wedding planners and drop a love sum to cover costs, while the poor struggle to put everything together and save money. A lot of people get help from their friends, family, when planning a wedding, even if they don't admit it openly. I have seen cases where one family takes over catering expenses while a group of friends handle drinks and cakes. It's normal, it's totally fine. But where does that leave a man without a lot of money to start his new life with? He might need a bigger house, which would cost money. Children will come, and that's also a money guzzler. So is Solomon Buchi ready for all this? How long will he continue to ask for help? I understand that some financial setbacks are temporary, but that's only if you reduce the cost of the setback, not add to it. How would getting married right now help this struggling man? A lot of Nigerian men are in this situation too, and it's not funny. I was in a WhatsApp group when a guy dropped his wedding list and bank account details for people to donate. When children comes, they will repeat the same. I don't blame Solomon for not having enough money to give his lady her dream wedding. But if they are going to rate this together, then they need to be on the same page. They need to plan accordingly and take their time till they are ready. They need each other and must work together. Lastly, I also understand what regard this issue, and some are saying is because he asks women for money. If he had begged men for money and then tweeted that women should stop dating broke men, DM screenshot will show up too. After all, men post screenshots of their chats with broke women on the timeline all the time. So everything started from that tweet. Social media cruise is fun to a certain point when single, but when you are about to face the real deal marriage, you need to show a level of maturity and leave some topics behind. My correct people, then, with all these things, we wanna don't see ya. Waiting wanna go advise this girl now if she be wanna sister. Because for me, I dey see red flag. Oh, honestly, men wait till they talk like this. Ha, now serious red flag. Oh, is well. All right, move to the country. People talk. All right, the first person say, if you live in a glass house, don't throw stones. You can't confidently broke shame women when you are always begging. You are not saying don't ask for help, but
practice what you preach. All right, another person say, my own be say, if you want marry, no go do pass yourself. Plan according to what you have. If na wedding you won't do, if na money for small chops you get, invite only your family and friends for the wedding. Do your small chops and share, give them, and everybody will go their house, go chop. Plan yourself. Stop competing with people. I don't even go wedding where they don't even give food. So after church, everybody go in house. All right, first person here say, Nigerians don't get chill. They brought out receipts. Then the second say, practice what you preach. They thought a nigger played himself. What happens to people that do this thing called I too know and speak plenty of English? Ah, my sister, you really know the coco. Now I too know one finish this guy, so speak plenty English. Because if we speak English, if you say you did correct and you did right on everything, no now. Instead of to they beg that money, why not you channel people to YouTube? At least if Instagram know they pay you, maybe you know they fit do influencing for people get money. Why not you come to YouTube? Your colleague, Blessing CEO, she's on YouTube cashing out. She the hustle here, even past Teresa. Post videos all the time. Why not you enter YouTube? At least even if you don't get influencing job, instead of to they beg people, won't it be better? Well, my great great people, them on, I saw the matter here, I said there, and I saw they take cast them. Who send them to go to talk to women like that when you they go beg them for secret? All right, Una, thank you so much for watching. Una, stay beautiful. Una, bye.